This is the Vernier digital radiation monitor, and it's used to measure radiation. We have a nuclear radiation with Vernier manual. It's used in some of the more advanced chemistry manuals. So if you're studying radioactivity, that's a tool you would use. It measures alpha, beta, gamma, and X-ray radiation. And the way it works is that the radiation has to come in through this port here, especially the alphas. Some of the sources like gamma rays, it's going to come right through any direction. But behind this window here, there's a little screen. Behind the window there's a mica window that allows the alpha radiation to come through. One thing you want to be careful about here is that if somebody pokes something in there, you can damage that window and mess that up. So you don't want to do that. And so behind the window, there's a Geiger-Müller tube. What happens is the radiation comes in, it ionizes the gas, and you end up with a current that's proportional to the amount of radiation that's coming in. Now, the device is powered by a 9-volt battery. So there's just a 9-volt battery in the compartment there. And there's a on-off switch, and it has off, on, and audio. And if I actually turn it on into that audio mode, that's where you get that clicking sound when it detects a radiation there. So we'll leave it there. So there we heard a click. And then above this, there's another button here, and this allows you to have different settings for when you're using this as a standalone device. Right now I've got it set in the total mode, and so it's actually just measuring the total counts as it comes through. This middle one is counts per minute, and then there's millirentgens per hour, so you can have it set there. And you'll notice there's some other smaller print here, and these are some other settings, and to activate these, you're actually going to end up turning the device on while holding down some of these other buttons. And I'm not going to go into great detail about that. And the reason for that is because we've got a couple of manuals that you can get. One, this one comes with the device, and so it's kind of the general basics of how you would use this one. It's available at the website, but it comes with it. But then there's this one, and it's available only at the website, which is a more advanced user guide for the device. And so some of those other settings and how you go about setting them up is in there. So. I'm just going to use it kind of in a normal use case and how we might use it with our device here. So I'm going to use it to collect a little data here. I have this glass dish. This is called Vaseline glass. It's the common name. It turns out that this color is actually caused by uranium. And so when they made it, they put uranium dioxide in there, and that's a part of the colorant, so it's radioactive. It's largely an alpha source, if I'm not to, it's okay for me to be near it, because it kind of falls off pretty rapidly here. But you can see, like right now, I've got it just sitting here, and it clicks occasionally, if you can hear that, and if I move it over close to the dish there, then it starts to click rapidly. So we're getting obviously some more radiation. So I'm holding that mica window next to the dish. So what I would like to do is to use this in conjunction with the LabQuest 2 to collect data and maybe look at the number of counts in a time period. And to do this, I'm going to attach it to the LabQuest via this special cable. And so this is the digital radiation monitor cable. And so it plugs into the side of the digital radiation monitor here. So you plug it in there. And then it plugs into the LabQuest in one of the digital ports. So I'll maybe put it in digital port one there. And now we see the meter, and it says digital radiation in channel one for digital port. And right now it's giving me counts, and it starts off zero. But that's the number of counts that occurred since it's been plugged in. And so as it goes through and clicks, we'll get some counts moving on there. If we take a look at this upper right corner here, it says time-based. So it's going to look at samples as a function of time. The rate is 0.1 samples per second. So every 10 seconds, it's going to make the actual measurement. And really what it's doing, it's counting the number of clicks that occurred during that interval, and that's what it displays. So we end up with a graph of counts as a function of time. And so that's what's happening here. Now, a common thing that will happen sometimes is people will see the number on the meter here, and they'll look at the screen of the digital radiation monitor, and they'll see that the numbers are different. Well, this is the number of counts that has occurred since I plugged it in, so those numbers don't really relate to each other, so that's what's happening there. So we're ready to collect data, and what will happen is I'm going to press collect, and when we do this, you're going to see a little spinning wheel, and that's because what's happening is it's sitting there and collecting the data, and there's nothing to display yet until that 10 seconds has elapsed. Once 10 seconds has elapsed, it's going to display the number of counts that occurred during that interval. So I've collected data for a few minutes. Now I'm going to put it near my source. And now I'm going to slip my shield, my paper shield, between the glass and the mica window. So now our data collection is complete, and we can take a look at our graph here. So there's our section when I'm furthest away from the device. Here is the when I put it near the device, so we see, you know, that how close I am to the our radioactive source here matters, and so the closer I am to do that. And then in this point right in here, I inserted the paper shield, and it does seem to shield a little bit some of the radiation reaching the detector there. And so we can take a look at that if we wanted to. I might want to come in and actually look at some of the values there. And so to do this, I might come in and say, well, let's just highlight this region of the graph. Maybe I'm interested in the stats. What is the average over that time period? And so if I go here, I end up with a mean of 2 counts per interval there. And if I go back to here, I could come and I could turn off stats and then highlight, say, the region when it's near our source. And so now I'm getting 33, so it's definitely a lot more. And then if I go back here and want to do the stats, say, for the region where I went from, say, here to here, then I can do the stats for that region, and I'm getting 25. So we did get some blocking with our paper shield. So we've seen a use case using it directly with the LabQuest as standalone, where we measured some radiation here. We did it a little bit as a function of distance, where we had it away from there and then brought it near there. So that's a typical lab that you might do. Did a little shielding activity there. So that's another kind of thing that you might do. There are shielding labs where you use different kinds of shields, lead shields or whatnot. So we've seen it this way. Now I'm going to do another collection, and I've actually already done the collection. I'm going to share with you what I've done. It's a previously saved file. And what I did was collect data over about an hour and a half of this being on the this source. And so we'll get to see that radiation.
And the top graph is just a graph of the counts per time. And we see some variability there. But the bottom graph is the histogram. So it's telling me the frequency with which different counts occurred in a given time period. And so this might be something that you would typically do with the radiation monitor. So this is, does require that you collect data over quite a bit of time in order to get a good histogram. And you could go and fit that with a Gaussian and see what the distribution looks like. To do the Gaussian, all I need to do is go up to Curve Fit option, and I have different choices here, and I've actually already selected the Gaussian, so you can see that you've got some different options here. And so I went down, I checked Gaussian, I do Try Fit, and say OK, and now I have my Gaussian display.
The Vernier digital radiation monitor, it's useful for being able to measure alpha, beta, gamma, and X-ray sources. So if you're doing labs that involve nuclear physics, it's definitely the sensor to use.